Hi, my name is Frank, and I'm working in the technical support of PLCnext Contact. Today I want to show you how you can turn a normal PLCnext Axioline control into an inline control, where you can use classical inline slides. How is this possible? Quite easy, with one of those beauties. What is that? This is an inline adapter slide, which you can attach to the right side on the PLC. This is working pretty easy with one of those adapter modules. Well, very tiny and small, but it works very easy, like for a classical Axioline local bus module. How is it working? You have to dismount the Axioline control from the DIN wire as follows. First of all, switch off the power, of course. So it's out. Then release the plug here. Release the next one here. Ethernet cable is gone. Then with a screwdriver, the orange connectors. First one. And then the second module. And you see here the, I guess, well-known Axioline backplane connectors. So release this one. We don't need it in this case any longer. And replace it for the one from the inline adapter. Plug it in, bring it together, and then that's it. Mount again the Axioline control. Click. Then use the inline adapter slide. Put it directly next to the PLC. Then power to the controller. And now I already prepared inline power plug. And I guess you know it. You can plug it to the device. Well, nearly I forgot. I need an IO module, like a digital out 8 HD. So, power on the device. And then switch the power on and the system is booting up. What we have to do now is to configure now the inline local bus in PLCnext. After rebooting, you can see that the local bus is already active, but there is no configuration of the I/O ports, so we have to go back to PLCnext Engineer to configure the whole thing. Let's have a look. I've prepared already a small demonstration project where I'm using an Axioline control 2152 as a PLCnext control and the normal Axioline local bus, in this case a digital in, digital out module. To use now inline on this controller, you have to configure the hardware extension for INTERBUS. So go to the PLC configuration, hardware extension, and choose for INTERBUS the Axioline control inline adapter slide. Now you can see that the local bus configuration changed from Axioline to inline adapt. So go to the device list. Here you can choose your inline devices, but without inserting the inline library you will now see any modules. So most important, before starting to configure your bus, you have to include the inline library. You can do that as follows. Go to libraries, add library, choose inline, open. Then you can see that in the hardware network inline modules are there, and now you can choose your needed modules. In my case I mounted digital output module. I choose digital output 8 identity. So now the only thing you have to do now is to change the port configuration. Because before I configured my output, this one, to the Axioline module, and this is not longer there. So I choose now here the inline module. And in fact, it's a very simple blinker application. Nice and easy. So, that was all. Connect now with the PLC, go to the cockpit, choose TCP IP, connect. then you are asked for your credentials, it's admin, and the password. The password, as you surely know, is printed on the PLC. Press enter. Now you're connected with the PLC. Just wait and starts a project. And now I can show you that the system is working. Now you can see here it's an easy blinker application, but that the process data are exchanged and that the application is running. So what is also most important in most cases is where I can find the diagnostics information, because every local bus or bus system needs diagnostics. For that we go back to the PLCnext Engineer. We go to the online view, to the debug view, it's already activated, and open the system variables on the field PLC. So I will enlarge this window. So by scrolling down, you see here the diagnostics from the Axioline local bus. This is now everything deactivated. And here you can find now the diagnostics for the INTERBUS. Well, we're happy, we have at the moment no errors, but here you can find any diagnostics information for the bus. Well, I hope you enjoyed this short tutorial video. See you next time. Bye bye.